Hi, and welcome to another exciting episode of Nerd Notes. I'm your host, Coach Stolliger. The 21st century is an exciting time to be alive, and new technological innovations make the world a better place every day. Some of the technology that might seem to be cutting edge has actually evolved over hundreds and sometimes thousands of years. Take writing, for example. Egyptians developed hieroglyphics over 5,000 years ago. Since then, we've developed hundreds of written languages and then devolved into using symbols for everything again, like emojis. One technology that seems to be key to our future is the use of rockets for space exploration. But rockets in some form have been around for nearly 1,000 years. Stan the Spaceman and I can tell you all about it. So prepare for liftoff, everybody. This is Nerd Notes. Rocket Man!
Hollywood is fascinated with rockets in space. There are numerous films devoted to them, and rocket launchers are one of the most popular tropes in action movies over the last 3 decades. Today's rockets are remarkable collections of human ingenuity that have their roots in the science and technology of the past. They are the evolution of centuries of experimentation and research on rockets and rocket propulsion. However, just when the first true rockets appeared is unclear, as stories of early rocket-like devices appear sporadically through the historical records of various cultures. In the 10th century AD, the Chinese created a simple form of gunpowder and experimented by using it as rocket fuel by filling bamboo tubes. During the Battle of Kaikeng in 1232, the Chinese repelled Mongolian invaders with a barrage of arrows of flying fire. These fire arrows were a simple form of solid propellant rockets. By the 16th century, rockets fell into a time of disuse as weapons of war, though they were still used for fireworks displays. A German firework maker, Johann Schmidlap, invented the step rocket, a multi-stage vehicle for lifting fireworks to higher altitudes. A large skyrocket, or stage one, carried a smaller one into the sky. When it burned out, the smaller stage two continued to higher altitude before showering the sky with glowing cinders. Schmidlap's idea is basic to all rockets today that go into outer space. A Russian schoolteacher, Konstantin Tsiolkovsky, proposed the idea of space exploration by rocket in a report he published in 1903. For his ideas, careful research, and great vision, Tsiolkovsky has been called the father of modern astronautics. Also in the 20th century, an American, Robert Goddard, conducted practical experiments in rocketry. He became convinced that a rocket could be propelled better by liquid fuel, but no one had ever built a successful liquid fuel rocket before. It was a much more difficult task than building solid propellant rockets, but he achieved the first successful flight with a liquid propellant rocket on March 16, 1926. Fueled by liquid oxygen and gasoline, it flew over 2.5 seconds, climbed 12.5 meters, and landed 56 meters away in a cabbage patch. By today's standards, the flight was unimpressive, but like the first powered airplane flight by the Wright brothers in 1903, Goddard's gasoline rocket was the forerunner of a whole new era in rocket flight. In Germany, the formation of the Society for Space Travel led to the development of the V-2 rocket, which was used against London during World War II. Once launched, the V-2 was a formidable weapon that could devastate whole city blocks. Fortunately for London and the Allied forces, it came too late in the war to change its outcome. With the fall of Germany, many unused V-2 rockets and components were captured by the Allies, and many German rocket scientists came to the United States and were amazed at the progress Goddard had made. On October 4, 1957, the world was stunned by the news of an Earth-orbiting artificial satellite launched by the Soviet Union. Called Sputnik 1, the satellite was the first successful entry into a space race between the two superpower nations. This led the United States to develop the Saturn V rocket. It was used by NASA between 1967 and 1973 to support the Apollo program for human exploration of the moon and was later used to launch Skylab, the first American space station. The Space Shuttle Solid Rocket Boosters, or SRBs, were the first solid fuel motors to be used for primary propulsion of a vehicle used for human spaceflight and provided the majority of the launch thrust during the first 2 minutes of flight. After burnout, They were jettisoned and parachuted into the Atlantic Ocean, where they were recovered, examined, refurbished, and reused. The SRBs were the most powerful solid rockets ever flown and the most advanced until the development of the SpaceX Falcon Heavy. This liquid-filled rocket was designed to carry humans into space beyond low Earth orbit, especially to the Moon, Mars, and potentially to asteroids for mining. It was first launched in February of 2018 and carried a Tesla Roadster belonging to the company founder Elon Musk, who might also be a Bond villain, into orbit as a dummy payload. Falcon Heavy is unique because the rockets are designed to detach and allow it to return directly to the launch pad.
Whether you're looking to have a good time celebrating a holiday with some fireworks, or reaching for the stars with the next generation of space explorers, the technology behind rockets makes it all possible. Just remember, like Nick Fury says, it's all fun and games until someone loses an eye. Play it safe out there and keep on chasing greatness, doing what you love. See you next time. Rocket Man.
Do you like videos like this? You can find me on YouTube at Hero City EdWorks or follow me on Twitter at Hero City Kevin.